and the students. If it's a B.Ed. college, I am sure that the students today will be teachers of tomorrow. And we had a wonderful depiction of Samvidhan, which we have seen. But certain things which probably because of the shortage of time to shoot a particular film escapes notice. I'll try to highlight those aspects to you. First of all, the Constitution of India is a wizardy. It's a magical document. Having studied various constitutions of the world, I have realized certain special features of the Constitution of India. Firstly, that it is the lengthiest constitution of any country in the world. When I say it is lengthiest, it has become lengthier from the day it has been promulgated. Actually, it came into operation on 26 January 1950, but it was passed by the Constituent Assembly on 26 November 1949. And on that day, the Constitution of India had 395 articles and 8 schedules. As on today, with more than 100 amendments to our Constitution of India, the number of articles have been added, increased, and on the last count, if I remember, there are 444 articles and 12 schedules in our Constitution of India. And when I say it is a wizardy, it's a magic. So I say with purpose. You just heard that there's one thing called preamble to the Constitution of India. Now, as you must be aware, that for any transaction, there are two sides which are required. Somebody to give, somebody to take. Can there be a transaction with only single party? No. But see the beauty of the preamble. It begins with the words, "We the people of India." And it ends with the word, "Give unto ourselves this Constitution of India." So who's the giver? We the people of India. And who's the taker? We the people of India. A wizardy in itself, that the whole transaction is happening between the same people. We the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic. You must be wondering how I said 5 things when the film depicted only 3. Because on that day, the preamble had only 3 features. Today with amendment, it has become 5. Secular and socialist had been added later, in the year 1976, when the 42nd amendment of the Constitution took place. The beauty of the Constitution is that you had seen a lot of discussions happening in the Parliament by our legislative fathers at that era, but we had the wisdom to accumulate whatever best the world could give to us. So we had borrowed certain provisions from the United Nations Charter. We had borrowed something from the US Constitution. We had borrowed certain provisions from UK Constitution, and so on and so forth. The Bill of Rights of the UN Charter became the fundamental rights into the Indian Constitution. That is part 3 of the Constitution of India. But the most most interesting part which you must have observed was the directive principles of the state policy, which is the part 4 of the Constitution of India. So what are these directive principles? Because fundamental rights, we all know, they are enforceable in the court of law. But we may not have heard much about the directive principles of the state policy. In simpler terms, if I make you understand, directive principles means what our legislative fathers, despite their best of efforts, could not achieve on the day of the promulgation of the Constitution of India. So they have left certain directives to the succeeding governments to achieve in future. Jo hum hasil nahi kar sake, jin swapno ke Bharat ko hum banana chahte hain par aaj nahi bana pa rahe, hum un ummeedon ko aane wali sarkaron par chhod kar ja rahe hain. और वो उम्मीदों की लिस्ट है डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स. और उन्हीं डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स में बड़े इंपॉर्टेंट प्रिंसिपल्स जो आपके संबंध में हैं, आपसे संबंधित हैं, मैं आपको बताता हूं. उन्हीं डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स में है आर्टिकल 45, उन्हीं डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स में है आर्टिकल 46, जो एजुकेशन पर बात करता है. जो हमारे लेजिस्लेटिव फादर्स ने ख्वाब देखा कि हमारी आने वाली जनता लिटरेट हो, पढ़ी लिखी हो, क्योंकि जब भारत स्वतंत्र हुआ तो बहुत कम परसेंटेज लिटरेट था और ओवरनाइट वो सबको लिटरेट बना नहीं सकते थे. तो उन्होंने आर्टिकल 45-46 में ये मेंशन किया दैट द सक्सेसिव गवर्नमेंट्स शैल एंडेवर टू प्रमोट एजुकेशन एंड मोर इंपॉर्टेंट दीज आर्टिकल्स से टू प्रमोट एजुकेशन अमंग बैकवर्ड क्लासेस, to promote education among women. और उसके बाद अगर आप देखें जो हमारी नेशनल एजुकेशन पॉलिसीज बनी, तो हमारे देश की पहली सरकार पंडित जवाहरलाल नेहरू के अंदर जो बनी, उसके पहले शिक्षा मंत्री थे मौलाना अबुल कलाम आज़ाद, जिनको अभी आपने देखा. और स्वतंत्रता के तुरंत बाद 1948 में एक यूनिवर्सिटी एजुकेशन कमीशन का निर्माण हुआ. 48-49 इट वर्क्ड, देन 52-53 सेकेंडरी एजुकेशन कमीशन का निर्माण हुआ. एंड देयर आफ्टर इन द ईयर 1964-66 देयर वाज वन कोठारी कमीशन टू गिव रेकमेंडेशंस अबाउट द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एजुकेशन इन इंडिया. इसी बीच 1961 इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट लैंडमार्क ईयर इन इंडियन एजुकेशन हिस्ट्री, जब हमारे देश में IITs एस्टैब्लिश हुए. उसी 1961 में NCERT का गठन किया गया, नेशनल कमीशन ऑफ एजुकेशन फॉर रिसर्च एंड ट्रेनिंग. कोठारी कमीशन को रिकमेंडेशंस को इंप्लीमेंट करने के लिए नेशनल पॉलिसी ऑफ एजुकेशन अंडर द लीडरशिप ऑफ इंदिरा गांधी वॉज कॉन्स्टिट्यूटेड इन द ईयर 1968, जिसमें आर्टिकल 45 के डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स को इंप्लीमेंट करने का एक प्रयत्न किया गया. And in this first education policy, it was contended that every child up to the 14 years shall be educated, shall be given education. and it will be the duty of the successive governments to provide that. Three language formula was first of all introduced by 1968 education policy. That means every student must be given three languages of knowledge: Hindi, English, and the local language of the region or the area which the student is studying. Aur jo three language policy hum aaj bhi follow kar rahe hain. In that first education policy, it was decided to encourage Sanskrit because it is our ancient language. And a very important financial decision was taken that 6% of the national income would be devoted to education. To kitna mahatv hamare संविधान के डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल के तहत एजुकेशन को दिया गया। अगर आप आर्टिकल 15 देखें, जो कि फंडामेंटल राइट है, सब क्लॉज 5 कहता है कि एवरीबॉडी विल हैव अ लिबर्टी टू हैव एलिमेंट्री एजुकेशन. Even if you see Article 26, 28, 29, 30, religious minorities have been given liberty to establish their own institutions. Though 28 and 29 says that the state-funded institution shall not have religious teachings. And it also prohibits that nobody will be deprived admission in state-funded educational institutions. तो बहुत सारी कोशिशें की गईं. 1986 में under then Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi, second education policy was brought. Thereafter, P.V. Narasimha Rao's government in 1992 brought another national policy for education. In conjunction, Dr. Manmohan Singh's government brought Common Minimum Program, where joint entrance examinations were introduced. And you may have seen that recent developments have happened in the field of education, where Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan, Rashtriya Uchchatar Shiksha Abhiyan, Rashtriya Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan, multiple efforts have been made by the government and the successive government. Recently, after the new government have been sworn under Prime Minister Mr. Narendra Modi, the first education minister in his cabinet was Ms. Smriti Irani, who established another commission, TSR Subramaniam Commission, which gave its recommendation. And currently, the current education minister, Mr. Prakash Javadekar, has established another commission under ex-ISRO chief K. Kasturi Rajan Commission. So these recommendations are coming. And all the governments are trying to encourage education. Aur agar aap notice kare, to the 86th Amendment of the Constitution was brought in the year 2002. क्योंकि इतने सारे फंडामेंटल राइट्स, डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल्स एंड कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल प्रिंसिपल्स, लाइक डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल 46, 45 मैंने बताया, फंडामेंटल राइट्स में 15, 26, 27, 28, 30 बताया, ऐसे ही कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल राइट्स भी हैं. आर्टिकल 350A विच टॉक्स अबाउट द एनकरेजमेंट ऑफ हिंदी, 351. These are constitutional rights. I'll explain you what are fundamental rights, what are constitutional rights. Fundamental rights are which are forming the rights under Part 3 of the Constitution. But there are rights which are not fundamental rights, but they are still constitutional rights, which are not forming within the Part 3 of the Constitution.